And of course, I smelled it like I was over and I said, what's it like, Sister Allen? I said, what is it like? She said, it's wonderful.
Yeah, praise God. Hallelujah.
Sister Masson, we went to a fellowship in Black's Harbor. And they gathered around and began to pray. And she spoke a word or two. And they said, she's got the Holy Ghost. And they dispersed. You know what happened? She came home disappointed.
Yeah.
But the next Sunday night, as the service progressed, God baptized her with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And this preacher, on purpose, walked to the back of the church to hear her speak in other tongues. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
I got a couple, three more stories I just need to tell you. Jimmy Lewis? No. Jimmy Ward. Wasn't Jimmy Lewis. Jimmy Ward needed the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And Brian Cole needed the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Jimmy was slain out in the middle of the floor. There was a great big old register there. But he missed that. And God filled him with the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Ryan saw what happened. He wanted the Holy Ghost. And he submitted himself to God. And God filled him with the Holy Ghost. The next thing I knew, here comes Jimmy. And here comes Ryan right behind me. They come up that side. They run over this side. They went down over there. They went around again. And they come up. I don't know how many laps they did. But God filled them with the Holy Ghost. Praise God.
Praise God.
Most of them never want to do that. They're the power of the Holy Ghost.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. I see elderly people get the Holy Ghost. I've seen young people like those four girls get the Holy Ghost. In fact, I baptized them a little later. They're trying to put the date on that. They just, one of them's got it and they're trying to get it back and forth and so on. I baptized them out here in Hartley.
Yes, sir.
And of course, Brother Roger talked about it. Baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I don't have time to tell you about the story of the Grudge and Ronnie Cole and Harold Cole and those folks having church and God filling them with the Holy Ghost. Brother McGuire, what God did for us in the 60s, He wants to do for you in 2013 and 2014. And we just have to believe God. Sang specials along with others. And I told him when I called him about coming, I said, Brother McGuire, I'll pray for you. I'll come back and preach. I didn't know that I was going to be here tonight 1 year later. But I'm glad to be here. And I'm glad to tell you tonight that God wants to fill every one of you with the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. He said, I don't need the Holy Ghost, preacher.
Oh, yeah.
Pardon me.
Come on, sir.
Don't tell this preacher you don't need the Holy Ghost, because what you're telling me is, I don't need Jesus.
Yeah.
Because
right.
Jesus
That's
said,
right.
I am with you, but I shall be in you. And Jesus also said, it's expedient for you that I go away, because if I go not away, the Comforter will not come.
Right.
But if I go, I'll send the Comforter to you. And when the Comforter has come, He will lead and guide you into all truth.
Yeah.
You.
Amen.
You need the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
You need to be filled.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
I'm here to declare to you. tonight.
Lord, thank you, Jesus.
The baptism of the Holy Ghost is for everybody.
Yes, sir.
And the day of God filling men and women is not over.
Come on, sir.
I got an email just this week about a mighty outpouring of the baptism of the Holy Ghost in Mexico. An outpouring of the Spirit of the living God. I'm not talking about 3 or 4. I'm talking about over 2,000 being filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. Praise God. Said, well, God can do it in Mexico. God can do it in Harvey Station tonight. After the Greer, God's still the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Lord, hallelujah.
He wants to fill you with the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
She does. Something.